group of researchers are in the middle of the Panama Canal on their way to an island called Barro, Colorado.
Actually, this is where I do my research, studying lianas.
And this is a unique island for the study of all sorts of things, ranging from tropical forest dynamics to animal behavior and species interactions. But what makes this island so special? Is it the unique formation caused by the creation of the canal? Maybe it's because there's easy access to this isolated and protected area where scientists can stay and work. Or possibly it's because with each study that is conducted here, we gain basic knowledge that combines synergistically with results from other studies, in the end giving us a better picture of this system. In reality, it's most likely a combination of all these factors which has led to the rich history of research on the island. So let's do a quick review. Barro, Colorado Island was formed when the canal was completed in 1914. And ever since its creation, it's been used for research. If we could take a journey through the history of BCI, represented graphically here, we would find an ever-growing amount of research that sheds light on broad scientific theories. Because of this research over the last century, there's probably no other tropical forest in the world that's been studied as much as this one. The Smithsonian Tropical Research Institute was declared in 1966 to administer BCI and the other marine stations in Panama. In 1977, Barro, Colorado, along with five surrounding peninsulas, became a protected natural monument. And today, elaborately equipped research labs allow scientists and grad students like myself to more easily conduct studies on the island. And a group of game wardens patrol the island to keep the forest free from poachers. So it's a combination of the location, history, and ease of access which have allowed researchers to study many facets of the biology of BCI, and in turn enlightened our understanding of tropical forests around the world. We'd like to take you behind the scenes to see some of the research projects on the island. These projects represent parts of larger themes of research, and while this is far from being a comprehensive list, it will give you insight into a few of the exciting studies underway. One of the most valuable studies has been the long-term monitoring of the world's first large tropical forest plot. 35 years ago, researchers working with the Smithsonian realized that the only way to effectively understand tropical forest dynamics was to study them on a large scale for a long time. And this led to a massive project in which scientists set up a 50-hectare plot, which is about 120 acres, in the middle of the island, in which every tree over 1 centimeter in diameter was measured, marked, and mapped, and then recensused every 5 years. Now we're beginning to census the lianas. The plot contains around 250,000 stems of about 300 tree species, and after 25 years of data collected from the plot, biologists are beginning to answer important questions about the maintenance of diversity. The nice thing about studying plants is that they don't move. Studying animals, however, requires a much different approach. Hunting has nearly been eliminated on BCI, which makes it an ideal place to study the ecology of animals. Many animals offer valuable ecosystem services such as pollination, pest control, nutrient cycling, and seed dispersal. And finally, before we can make informed conservation decisions, we must understand the biology of individual species and the many ways in which they depend on each other. But many animals are cryptic and hard to find. To study them often requires following the lives of the same individuals. Researchers have in the past solved some of these problems by placing tracking devices on animals and used radio telemetry to manually track them. But this method still requires a great deal of labor to find and track each animal. But this need not be the case. On BCI, modern technology has allowed biologists to set up the Automated Radio Telemetry System, or ARTS project, which has automated much of the labor involved in studying animal movement. With this single system, an animal is fitted with a unique radio tracking device, which is identified by a series of towers on the island. These towers then send the location of the animal to a computer system. With several towers picking up the signal, the exact position of the animal can be viewed on a computer back in the lab or online. Researchers can tell when an animal is active, resting, and exactly when and where it dies. This allows researchers to gain data on rare events that would otherwise have been impossible. Today, researchers are doing even more with the system. They're tracking bats, moths, sloths,
agoutis, and even bees. And possibly the most exciting thing is that they're advancing our understanding of how animals interact with other species. The study of species interactions has been a major topic of research on the island. Research has focused on diverse topics from herbivory to pollination, but no one study can typify all forms of investigation. For example, scientists have asked the question, why is the world green? Why don't herbivores devour what appears to be an ample supply of food? They found that the answer lies in a combination of tough leaves, abundant plant toxins, and the effect of predators upon herbivores. Scientists have also asked questions about complexities of pollination pathways using animals like orchid bees, which are one of the most important pollinating insects in the forest. Scientists on BCI are utilizing this unique research island to help unravel the mysteries surrounding these important species. While BCI acts as a research haven where scientific research thrives, it is also a sanctuary where anyone can come to learn about the forest. Visitors of all types come here to observe the flora and fauna, and many only see a glimpse of the island, a virtual snapshot of a tremendous puzzle. Meanwhile, scientists work to unravel the intricacies of the forest and further our understanding of tropical ecosystems. Today, Barro, Colorado Island is influencing research around the world. The 50-hectare plot on BCI, for instance, has spawned 19 other plots around the globe, managed through the Center for Tropical Forest Science, or CTFS. With these data, we're trying to understand how tropical forests as a whole function in our changing world. And maybe the most important thing we can do is to continue studying the mysteries of the forest. In fact, it's critical that we do so, because with each question we answer, more will arise. And so it's this combination of scientific study, a unique location on the globe, and the dissemination of this knowledge that make Barro, Colorado Island truly unique.